You want your website to rank in the search engines, right? Not all pages on your website are fit for ranking, though. Think, for example, of thank you pages, on which you thank your visitor for subscribing to your newsletter or for buying a product. You don't want these pages to be found in the search results. Is there a way to block them from Google? Yes. As a matter of fact, you can give search engines instructions on how you'd like them to crawl or index parts of your website. For these instructions, you can use meta robots tags on your pages. Yoast SEO makes this communication process a lot easier. In this video, I'll show you how. We'll discuss the configuration wizard, the Yoast SEO search appearance settings, and the advanced tab in the Yoast SEO meta box. Let's open the configuration wizard and take a look at step 4. Okay, what does it say? Please specify what content types you would like to appear in search engines. If you do not know the differences between these, it's best to choose the default settings. Okay, so if you choose no for one of the content types you have, Yoast SEO will add a no-index robots meta tag to these pages. And the message of this tag is, you guessed it, don't index these pages. Let's move on to step 5. Does or will your site have multiple authors? Now read along. If you choose no, your author archives will be deactivated to prevent duplicate content issues. What does that mean, duplicate content issues? And where do they come from? Well, if you are the only one writing for your blog, your author pages are probably 90% the same as your blog homepage. That's called duplicate content. And it's bad for your SEO, so you don't want that. To prevent this kind of duplicate content, you can choose to disable the author archive entirely. You can do that by choosing no. But if you, for some reason, would like to keep your author archive on your site, but out of the search results, you can no-index it. Let's go to the search appearance settings of Yoast SEO to show you how this works. First, close the wizard. Then click Search Appearance in the menu on the left. Now let's click the Archives tab. If you selected No in step 5 of the configuration wizard, your author archives will be disabled. However, if you want to keep them, switch the toggle to Enabled and two more toggles will appear. Switch the second toggle to No if you don't want to show your author archives in the search results. Yoast SEO will then add a no-index robots meta tag. The third toggle only affects the archives from authors without posts. If you have multiple author archives, you can also no-index one or some of them. Make sure your author archives are enabled here. Click Save, and then go to Users. Now select the author whose archive you want to no-index. Scroll all the way down and click this box. Do not allow search engines to show this author's archives in search results. Easy, right? Now, let's get back to the search appearance settings because there's more that I would like to show you. Let's go to the Archives tab once more. In addition to author archives, you can also decide whether you want to show date archives in the search results. Use the second toggle and switch it to Yes or No. Okay, let's move on to the Content Types tab. This tab shows all the content types you have. Posts, pages, and custom post types like locations if you use the Yoast Local SEO plugin, for example. The options you chose in step 4 of the wizard determine the settings you'll see here. So, if you decide to switch the toggle to No instead, Yoast SEO will add a no-index robots meta tag. Next, we have taxonomies. Category and tag archive pages can work really well as landing pages. But sometimes you might want to no-index these pages. On this tab, you can do that with the flip of a switch. Okay, so we've discussed the configuration wizard and the search appearance settings. But what about individual posts and pages? Can you no-index these as well? Of course! And again, Yoast SEO makes this process very easy. let's go to this thank you page. And then scroll down to the Yoast SEO meta box. Click the advanced header. If you don't want to show this page in the search results, I just change the default yes to no. The second question is about links. If you select no, Yoast SEO will add a nofollow MetaRobots tag to the page. If you do that, none of the links on that page will be followed. On a regular website, there are probably very few pages you'd want Google not to follow any link. Ask yourself, are all the links featured on this page trustworthy? Are the links you added valuable? For example, admin or login pages don't add value to your SEO. And third question, did you include paid or sponsored links? If all the links on a page are not safe, not valuable, or paid, you might want to discourage the search bots from following them. But hey, did you know that it's also possible to control individual links? Every time you insert a link, you can mark it as nofollow or sponsored. Convenient, right? Finally, we have three more robots meta tags you can set in the advanced section of the meta box. With no image index, you disallow search engines from crawling images on this page or post. No archive prevents the search engines from showing a cached copy of this page. And no snippet prevents the search engines from showing a snippet of this page in the search results and prevents them from caching the page. Alright, so now you know exactly how Yoast SEO can help you control where search engines go and what they're allowed to index. Good luck!